At any given time, there are about 18 flavors on display here at Premier. And what an assortment it is! Sea salt and Singapore's gula melaka and ice cream? Yes, please!
Thank you!
Thank you! Right? Okay, I'm getting the same thing too.
OMG! It's really good. I mean, you can really taste the gula melaka flavor.
Mm. Perfect mix of sweet
Perfect
and salty.
Perfect mix, and it's not so sweet, actually. Mm. In this place, they recommend you to pair two flavors of ice cream with another crowd favorite, their waffles. So we have freshly made waffles topped with gula melaka ice cream and charcoal black sesame ice cream.
And there's chocolate and maple syrup at the bottom.
Combined.
And powdered sugar.
Before it melts, let's try it out. Okay. But ladies first.
Fine. Okay, what I appreciate about this ice cream is that it's not fancy or over the top. Because some ice creams, they put so many things inside it. This allows you to appreciate the flavor because it's clean. Mm-hmm. It's just that. No add-ons, no chocolate chips, anything like that.
Wow. So even the waffles, it's very airy. It's not at all heavy.
Very light.
Yeah, it's very light. Singapore is a very hot and humid country, so having ice cream is a good idea.
Mm. But rain or shine, I'll definitely be eating this.
Well, same here. Another establishment serves chocolate in many, many, many ways.
Wondering where to start your chocolate adventure? Hot chocolate is always a good idea.
So today I opted to order the milk chocolate. So this is 45% chocolate and the rest is milk.
Can't wait to start mine.
Wow.
How is it?
Wow. It's so good. You know, it's amazing that they make their own chocolates. Mm. So from their drinks to the pastries, everything is made by Awfully Chocolate from scratch. How's yours?
Mm. So I've tried both the 60% and the 70%. One thing I noticed, this is a thicker body.
Oh.
They taste the same.
Okay.
I can't find any difference with the taste, but it's more of the color and the texture.
Is there bitterness in flavor?
Just slightly.
Okay.
So I think even the kids can appreciate this.
Nice. Almost everything here is infused with chocolate, even their butter. I love butter. Any kind of butter I enjoy, but butter with chocolate and dashi?
Mm.
Wow.
Mm. Salty.
Mm-hmm. It's salty. I can taste a little bit of bitterness from the chocolate, but the salt is more powerful than the cocoa.
Yeah.
But it's good. It's perfect with the bread. And of course, dessert here has to involve chocolate ice cream, right? It's good.
So smooth. It's bold. Not too sweet. Nicely churned.
Wow. You know, the sago, it bursts.
Mm.
So it's not a typical...
Same here.
...tapioca.
Mm.
So it's, once you bite into it, there's liquid coming out. And you can really taste the flavors of both the pomelo and the mangoes. But the pomelo, normally pomelo has a bit of bitterness.
Yeah.
But this one doesn't. It's sweet.
Whereas the dessert that I have, it's yuzu.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a bit tart. But it pairs well with the mago because mango sago because it's sweet.
So this one is yours, grandma's recipe.
Thank you. Yeah, you don't need collagen
you
anymore.
You need collagen.
Well, for starters, it smells so good. Mm-hmm. It has an endearing aroma. And tastes like ginumis, but not as sweet as ginumis.
Okay. And it has pears.
I can taste the pears, definitely. The goji berries too. Mm-hmm. And I like that it's warm because it's kind of soothing. With lychee, so good.
Mm-hmm. So it's a very unique dish because it has all kinds of texture in your mouth. Mm-hmm.
Very playful. Actually, the ice makes for a great base because it's not too sweet. And mm-hmm. so you can put a lot of add-ons mm-hmm. as much as you mm-hmm. want and really play around with it. If you want something fruity, you mm-hmm. can pick a mango burster, for example. So wow. I got the aboling with the peanut soup, and you have?
So I have the almond milk soup with different kinds of flavored balls. Mm. I can really smell the
yes.
almond.
How's very your, obvious that it's
how's
peanut.
Your peanut soup? Wow, I love almond mm. milk.
It's
one of
it's
my
warm.
Favorites.
And mine's chunky.
The peanuts, because yes, okay, there's sure. real peanut chips in it. Mine is just very smooth. It's not the usual almond milk soup that I have back home that's thick. Mm-hmm. So this one's nice, creamy, but
not super sweet.
Not so sweet.
Your teeth pierce through the ball easily, hardly any resistance. And so you don't end up like chewing the whole time.
Yeah. So the balls come in different colors. I guess the green would be the matcha
my
and
favorite.
The red one will be the red bean. Mm-hmm. Mm. Okay, how is it?
The bitterness of the matcha comes through.
There. I'm gonna cut it because it's too big. Wow, look at it! Normally you can't just cut this, but it's obvious that the skin is very soft that you can cut through it with a plastic spoon. There you go. Look at the inside. Super filled with peanuts. Mmm. Yeah. Yum. So when you're in Chinatown, you can have a great meal and finish it off with a delicious bowl of aboling peanut soup.
Happy when it comes to egg tarts. Hong Kong has Honolulu Cafe, Macau has Lord So's Bakery, and
Singapore has Tong Heng.
Let's order?
Yep.
What are you getting?
I will get the red bean pastry for the hopia, mm-hmm. and of course, their famous egg tart. Okay. How about you?
I'll probably get the lotus. I'm still deciding whether to get the lotus or the century egg because it sounds so interesting, a century egg in
Hong Kong. Actually, both sound interesting. Mm.
Go, let's do this.
Okay, so can I try the coconut egg
Yeah. So we ordered the coconut egg tart.
Yeah.
Can't resist.
There. As you can see, so the coconut egg tart has meat strips of coconut.
Mmm. Mm. Delicate pastry, delicate filling.
It's very creamy inside. Mm. It has strips of coconut meat and a bit of the juices. So mm-hmm. the combination is amazing. There you go, look at that. So, how's yours?
Century egg, yeah.
Century egg, is it sweet or like pure century egg?
It has something else, eh. There's an egg in the middle. Pero,
baka it has pork with it, maybe?
Kind of tastes like the sauce of chashu.
Oh yeah, so maybe they mix like the barbecue pork and century egg together.
good.
Mm-hmm. So, again, the lotus is very rich. Mm. But this style, really, it's not too sweet as well. So you can eat many. It's very different from the Hopia in Manila because the crust is a little thinner. Because in Hopia, the layering is more. So this one is thinner, yet the filling is very hefty. All in all, this is a unique bakery that you guys should definitely check out for dessert and also for pasalubongs. You wanna walk around? We can eat. We have the box.
Fine. I'll have the last pastry.
Okay, go.
You'll have
go
the
ahead.
Last egg
the
tart.
Last egg tart? Okay. Game. Let's go.
Let's go.